Hi, welcome to Alvaro's Insights once again. The word most used nowadays is Corona, Corona, Corona. Everyone talks about this word. Everyone uses this word a million times. What exactly is the etymology of the word Corona? I'm sure all will be interested in knowing that. So today, I'm going to explain the etymology of the English word Corona. First of all, let us check it out in the popular Etymon online search for the root. Corona, as per the popular website etymononline.com, is 1650s, a crown from Latin corona, meaning a crown, a garland. In ancient Rome, especially, a crown of garland bestowed for distinguished military service. From suffixed form of PIE, root scur, to turn, to bend. With many extended senses in botany, anatomy, etc., a coronavirus by 1969 is so called for the spikes that protrude from its membranes and resemble the tines of a crown or the corona of the sun. As per Merriam-Webster dictionary, this word corona means garland worn around the head as a mark of honor or emblem of majesty, a halo around the celestial body, top part of an entablature. Now we find this root is not quite acceptable for the following obvious reasons. This word has come into use only by AD 1650. That leads to the question, was there no coronations before AD 1650? If so, what was the word used for it? The attributed meaning of the word is garland or wreath. There is no history of any Roman or Greek king ever wearing a garland on his head for coronation. Though flower crowns were worn by Greeks and Romans, there's not a single image of any king wearing a flower crown found in the Google search. This leads one to doubt the very etymology claimed. Even in Olympic Games, laurel leaf crown was awarded to winners, not a flower garland. The Latin root does not have any related Latin words. Then what exactly is the etymology of the word corona? In ancient times, a king does not wear a crown just like that. It was a pretty elaborate process with a defined order of ceremonial procedures. Apart from common people, the ministers, the nobility, the army, high priest, etc., all assembled to witness the grand function and celebrate the king being crowned. Festoons were hung all around the town to mark the celebration. This order of celebration is called Thoranai. Thoranai, in the oldest surviving language of the world, that is Tamil. So Thoranai means the order of king's ascension to power. Thoranai also includes wearing a crown as well as hanging what is called Thoranam. Thoranam is festoons. This Thoranam is a festoon of mango leaves. According to Agaradi.com, the University of Madras lexicon says Thoranai is an order, arrangement, method, plan, as of a discourse, in Tamil, Murai. And Thoranam means cords hung with garlands, palm leaves, or cloth hung up to adorn a road in honor of an idol or a great person, or to garnish a house for a festivity, or the parts of a temple for an annual ceremony. The related words in Tamil are Thoranakkal, Thoranakkal, Thoranakkambam, Thoranankatta, Thoranam Thooka, Thoranam Poda, Thorana Deepam, Thorana Vilakku, Thorana Vail. So, Thorani in Tamil means order of king's ascension to power, and Thorana means festoons of mango leaves hung all over the place for celebration. In course of time, the meaning has corrupted into crown, flower, garland, etc. The words are Tamil as proved by the presence of collateral or related words listed above. The line of derivation of the word Latin English word corona is Tamil Thoranai, corrupting into Thorana, then Corona. Tamil Thoranam, corrupting into Thorana, then Corona. Unlike the English word, which is just a few hundred years old, the Tamil root word is more than 2000 years old. The genetic link between Tamil and PAE, Greek, Latin and English is well established already by the research book Proto-Indo-European Language, Face Unveiled, available in Amazon.com. The book establishes that all words relating to royalty in most languages of the world have their root in Tamil word Rasa, for king. Hence, it's not quite a surprise that the word for coronation also comes from Tamil roots. Thank you.